Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, let's talk about the behavior interview. Behavior interviews have become an essential part of landing any job at a major tech company. You must not only prove that you can do the job, but you must also show that you will be a good coworker and fitting well at the company if you wish to land an offer. Because behavior interviews are not technical, many candidates do not take the time to properly prepare for them. But you can easily lose your chances of getting a job by doing poorly in the behavioral interview. To help you with your preparation, this video will look at the do's and the don'ts of behavioral interviews. I will discuss how to make your answers more effective and what to avoid to prove to the interviewer that you are someone with whom they would want or love to work. Let's get started. First of all, what is a behavioral interview? To put it simply, the behavior interview aims to determine what kind of person you are. Companies don't just want to know if you have the knowledge to perform a job, they also want to know what you are like to work with. The behavior interview works to answer the latter question. There are three types of questions that help the interviewer do this: questions about the company, questions about you, and situational questions. These three types of questions cover your experience, capability, and values. We will begin with the positives, the do's, by looking closer at the three types of questions and the tip for dealing with each of them. The first type of question is questions about the company. This will be questions such as, why do you want to join the company? What do you value most at the company? The company asks these questions to judge how you fit within the company culture. Our tip for these questions is to do your research. Different companies have different environments because they have different values. A company wants to know if you share those values. At some companies, it will be important to show a willingness to think outside the box and share your ideas openly. At other companies, you will need to display capability to be proactive and thrive in ambiguity. It is important to be aware of the company culture so that you can illustrate the appropriate values in your interview. Of course, the only way you can show awareness of the company culture and illustrate that your values align is if you research the company. How would you research a company's culture though? Tech companies like Google, Amazon, Lyft, Uber, and Airbnb have company values and mission statements that you can find online. For example, Google lists being proactive as a quality of someone with Googliness. This means that Google wants employees that can anticipate what needs to be done and take actions ahead of time. This also means thinking about how we can bring the business further. Overall, it means looking to make things happen rather than waiting for others. So if you know that Google likes proactive people, you could say something about how you want to work at Google because you feel like you will fit into the action-oriented and forward-thinking environment. Knowing information like this allows you to more effectively show passion for a company. Companies want to know why you want a job with them specifically. By researching their values and what they look for in employees, you can demonstrate a genuine interest in the work and the goals of the company and show that your values align with the company. The next type of question is questions about you, which refer to questions about your experience and your capability. Some examples will be an intro question such as, tell us about yourself, or a question about your experience such as, describe an impact project. An interviewer is looking for things that prove you are an effective employee. Specifically, there are a few things a behavior interview seeks to establish about a candidate: your experience and capabilities. What relevant experience you had that can make you qualified for the position. Other parts of the interview process will evaluate your hard skills or technical knowledge. The behavior interview, however, looks at whether you have the non-technical skills that are essential for the job. This includes things such as communication skills, responsibility, and time management. Another aspect is your values. A company wants to know that your personal values align with your company values. These goals are the checkboxes you want to hit by the end of the interview. When answering questions about you, ensure that you show these things. Specifically, I recommend when introducing yourself, you want to not only talk about your experience, but also share why you're passionate about the company and the position. Even better, you are confident that you will be able to bring impact to the company based on your track record. This tip pairs well with our earlier tip about doing your research. Only if you research a company's values and think through what kind of candidate a company is looking for, you are able to use your experience and values to convince the interviewer you are a good fit. Other than demonstrating your capability, passion, and values, there's one more thing for behavior interviews that I want to highlight in this video: emphasize impact. This applies to one particular type of question that you will almost always be asked, which is describing a past project. When describing a past project, it can be easy to get caught up in the context and details of the situation. However interesting those details might be, you must remember that the interview is about you. The theme of your past project should always be the impact you had. It is so important that I recommend starting with the impact of your project before moving into the smaller details. That may sound strange, especially for those of you familiar with the STAR method. However, there are two reasons that putting impact near the beginning is a good idea: time limit and flexibility. You never really know how long the interviewer expects your answers to be. Therefore, it's risky to put the most important part of the answer, the impact, at the end. You want to make sure that you have plenty of time to highlight your achievements, which is why you should never leave the impact for last. While chronological order makes sense in many ways, it is also too rigid for a behavioral interview. In any interview, you want to interact with the interviewer and make the process feel like a conversation. Putting the impact at the beginning of your answer allows you to get the important information out of the way and have the interviewer guide the rest of the answer. You can ask them what details they would like to hear instead of delivering a rehearsed speech. If you want to learn more about my recommendations and the framework for describing past projects, you can check out my blog post on why the STAR method does not work and what to do instead. Now, let's move forward to the last type of question, the situational questions. These questions typically make up a large portion of a behavioral interview. This category can sometimes overlap with the questions about yourself, as you may be asked either to explain what you would do in a hypothetical situation or talk about some of your past experience. For example, a situational question might be, "Tell me about a time you had to work on a strict deadline." Or, "Imagine that you are working with an underperforming teammate. How would you handle that situation?" These questions require you to tell a story, but if you want to stand out, you need to go beyond just telling the story. Every question and every story is an opportunity to show why you're a good candidate. Use every story to show multiple good attributes of yourself. A question about leadership can also show good communication and responsibility. A story explaining a time you overcame an obstacle can also display empathy and time management. But what are good attributes for you to showcase in your stories? There are some common attributes that make a good employee in just any company. Some good attributes to highlight include: be proactive. You are a problem solver. You seek to get things done instead of simply waiting to be told what to do. Passion. Do you take a natural interest in your work? Showing a level of self-motivation and interest is crucial in any story. Flexibility. This goes beyond being flexible with your schedule. A flexible employee can adapt and operate in ambiguity. Leadership. Can you take charge and be a role model in your company? Leadership qualities like effective communication and a desire to have the team as a whole succeed are valuable skills even when applying for non-leadership positions. Empathy. You can see things from a different perspective. This means you work well with others and can constructively use feedback. Now, you may wonder, how does including multiple attributes in a single story work practically? Let's look at an example. Imagine that you are explaining a situation where you were working with an underperforming teammate. In this story, you can explain how you approached your teammate to ask if anything was wrong, and you try to help your teammate with finding a solution. This shows empathy and that you value communication. You may also have taken on more work because of your teammates' underperformance, which shows leadership and proactiveness. Now that we have looked at some things you do want to do in behavioral interviews, let's turn our attention to some things you want to avoid. Behavioral interviews are non-technical, and as such, they can often feel a bit more relaxed, especially when things are going well. However, it is still an interview, and you want to maintain your professionalism and be mindful of what you say. We will cover three red flags or don'ts that are common mistakes in behavioral interviews. The first thing to avoid is being blameful. When asked questions about your past experiences, some less than pleasant situations are bound to come up. You will be asked about conflict, obstacles, and failures. When discussing these things, resist the urge to blame others in your account, even if it really was someone else's fault. Being blameful will make you seem like an unfriendly coworker and not easy to work with. Focus instead on the actions you took to overcome the obstacle or resolve the conflict instead of dwelling on how it happened. For example, you might be asked how you dealt with a disagreement with a manager or a supervisor. Maybe your manager's strategy on a particular project was weak. When discussing this, you need to avoid dwelling on the manager's mistakes. Explain how you approached your manager, what you did to try to improve the situation, and what the results were. Do not spend a lot of time explaining why your manager was wrong and what they could have done better. Remember, the interview is about you, not your manager. The next don'ts have to do with specific questions that appear in the interview. Why do you want to work at this company? When asked this question, do not talk about things like work-life balance, perks, or compensation. Although these things might be a large reason for why you want a job, the interviewer does not want to hear about this. Emphasizing this yourself will only imply that you do care more about the benefit of the company than the job itself. So, what are things you can talk about? I recommend focusing on things like wanting to work in the industry, being eager to be surrounded by talented coworkers, or being interested in solving the type of problems the company deals with. You should indicate that you are interested in the work rather than just what you can get out of it. The final don't for this video concerns a part of the interview that we often spare little thought for, when you get to ask the interviewer questions. Asking questions is a good thing, but only if you avoid asking offensive questions. What are offensive questions? Asking anything that shows a clear bias or negativity can be offensive. Things like, how often do you work more than 8 hours per day? What is the most stressful thing about working here? And how many PhDs are on the team? Those questions give a bad impression about your priorities. Stick to positive questions for a behavior interview. Questions such as, what is the vision of the company? What gets you most excited about working here? Any interesting project you could share with me? Those kinds of questions not only help you get valuable information from the interviewer, but also show your positive attitude. Alright guys, that's some basic do's and don'ts for behavioral interviews. Let's do a quick recap. The three do's are do your research, do emphasize impact, and do show multiple attributes of yourself. The three don'ts are don't be blameful, don't talk about work-life balance, perks, or compensation, and don't ask offensive questions. That's everything I have for you in this video. If you're interested in learning more about behavior interviews or other types of interviews, subscribe to the channel to stay updated about future content. Thanks again for watching. I will see you soon.